Welcome to today's stream. We are going from Faversham to London on the southeastern high speed. Today we're going to be doing it in a Javelin, which is the faster train out of all of them. So let me just get myself set up. Hope everybody's well and having a good weekend so far. So I haven't been doing these videos much. Right, we've got about a minute until we do the set off. Have a look at the stops. So it's stopping at Sittingbourne, Raynham, Gillingham, Chatham, Rochester, Strood, Gravesend, Ebbsfleet International, Stratford International, and then St Pancras International. So it should take a little while to get there, but we'll do it. Trains loaded up. Let's go. Oh, already gone over the speed limit. It's 15 miles an hour. That's me thinking I was another part of the track. Right, let's get this. Oh, so what time are we on? Okay, 6.8 miles to go. We're due there at 11:38 and 30 seconds. Sorry about that. Controller fell. See, we'd be over this side. To 90 miles an hour. Just over 3 miles to go to where it's sitting. I wonder if it'd be sunny the whole time we're on this track, on this route I should say, because one good thing about this game, it does have dynamic weather, and it is still February, so we could see a bit of sleet, we could see some snow, or we could see some rain. Anything can happen. Over a mile to go now, and then we're at our first stop. Hopefully we can stop directly on the marker. Sitting Bone. Going a little bit too slow at the moment, so I must be just a little bit just so I can get there. We're still early, so that's good. Well, early-ish. We're about 10 seconds early. Not spot on, but close enough. Such a nice looking train as well. And when you connect the trains, these two open, so they're both, so that one goes that way, that side goes that way, and that's how you connect the trains. I don't know if I've actually got it in this train. No, I've got the normal train, not current double. But no, I have been one of these trains, and it is nice as it looks. Now I'm late leaving. Oh well, we'll pick it up. This train's normally good at picking up its speed. Raynham next. Don't know, but when we change to overhead power lines at Ebbsfleet. When you go to that one, it just seems like it's a lot more quicker when you're in kilometers an hour. Don't know why. But when you're on this route, this seems slow, this train does. This train's made to go quick. Because it's not electrified above the track. It's limited, I think. Which is kind of a shame, really. I think this whole service should be high speed. Who knows what the future holds? Hopefully they'll stop striking soon. That's getting quite annoying. Trying to get from a mate's house on this train, on this service, is you make plans and then you look at the train tickets and times and stuff, and then it goes, oh, we've got a strike. So now I can't travel. Sucks, but they're doing it for a good reason, so I do hope they get it sorted soon. Excuse me. think this is Newington. Yeah. Such a nice train. Start slowing this train down soon. Hopefully to about 30 and then let it roll in. Actually no, we need being down a little bit more because we're closer than I thought. But that should be alright. And there's another javelin from Ramsgate. Going to Ramsgate, I should say. Or Margate, I should say, on the front of that. No, I can't even look at it because I'm moving. Are you going to Margate? Come here! Nope, can't see it. I tried to catch it, see. I think that one is going to Margate. From St. Pancras to Margate. Closing the doors a little bit early so I get myself time to get out, get myself ready to go exactly on time. Right. Chillingham. Can't wait to change the overhead power lines because it makes the train go a lot quicker. We've got 3 minutes. Oh, we've got plenty of time to get there. We're only a mile and a half away. So I need to start doing a little announcements, because there's no announcements on this game yet. Well, on this route. Welcome aboard the Southeastern service to St. Pancras, calling at Chatham, Rochester, Stroud, Gravesend, Ebbsfleet International, Stratford International, and St. Pancras International. Next station is Chatham. stick it around about 50, because there's no point going up to 60, because it's about to go down again. Shortly be arriving at Chatham. Please make sure you got all your personal belongings with you at all times. Thank you for travelling on Southeastern Service. Now arriving at Chatham, please mind the gap between the train and the platform. Welcome aboard Southeastern Service to St. Pancras, calling at Rochester, Strood, Gravesend, Ebbsfleet International, Stratford International, and then St. Pancras International. Really do need to know these platforms off by heart by now, but still no luck.
Thank you.
station is Rochester. This old platform. Now arriving at Rochester, please make sure you have all your personal belongings with you at all times. Thanks for travelling on Southeastern's service. Welcome aboard to Southeastern service. To St. Pancras International, calling at Shrewd, Gravesend, Ebbsfleet International, Stratford International, and St. Pancras International. The next station is Shrewd. And it's starting to rain. Typical British weather. Welcome aboard the Southeastern Service to St. Pancras International, calling at Ebbsfleet International, Stratford International and St. Pancras International. I think I said that right. I've been asked if I did. So, it's Gravesend. Gravesend. I missed that Gravesend. But it was a nice day for a train drive, but not so much no more. About 10 seconds. Should be picking up speed by now. There we go. The wipe sound on this one is quite annoying, so that's why I was turning it off. I don't need it. I was hoping to catch some sparks, but it's not happening. Oh, there we go, that's a spark. Right, so we're about 5 miles to Gravesend, and after that we'll be going to Ebbsfleet International, changing from third rail to overhead cables, and then the train will be in kilometres an hour, and then we're going to go much faster. Now we're in a laggy part of the map again. Always seems to lag a little bit for a bit. A lag when we get towards Stratford International as well. Down to 50, about half a mile. Pretty well with the red lights at the moment. I don't think we have any issues until we get to St. Pancras. I think we might get a red light going in. Only happens occasionally. bringing down the speed. And then we're coming to Ginny Grave then, now. Yeah? The weather's changed quite dramatically. It was nice and sunny. I started off in Faversham and now I'm in Gravesend and it's totally opposite. Yeah, it's one of my favourite trains to drive, this one. I don't know if you're aware of this, but if you're above a road like this, if you put your camera in front of a car, it actually stops. And I think they start beeping as well. I'm not really here, mate, it's just in the camera. Cause a bit of a traffic jam before I go. Oh no, no man. Oh no, I've got time. I've got a little bit of time. Let's stop ya. Let's go in the middle. Let's go. So yeah, just some bit of information for you guys to know. I can get bored waiting until your time comes along. Something for you to do. Hope everybody is well and having a good weekend so far. Right. Watch out, remember the buttons now to if I remember correctly, I've got to hit that button until that light goes off. Yeah, I think I'm gonna hit that button. I think I wanna get there. I always seem to forget before I go to my station. But when I'm there, I'll sort of remember. The next part of this journey will be quite a lot of tunnels, especially like when we get closer to Stratford, or the first lag, as we get closer to London. So that's good. Yes, I know. I know I need to change it. Correctly press that button and then press that button and then press that button. So that means that should be up on the third rail, so it should be connected no more, which it isn't. And then a pylon at the back, well, not a pylon, but I always call it connector. There we go, the connector is up, and yes, it is. So we are. We're on kilometers an hour, so we are good to go. See, I'll always remember when I gotta press it. But when I come in to talk about it, I'm like, oh, what buttons is it? It's weird. Get these doors closed and let's get rid of some high speed action. We'll turn the wipers up for this bit. It just seems way faster already. Time and off it goes. 225 next, please. Thank you. So as we get closer to Stratford International, it does get a bit laggy. I think that's just because it's trying to build everything in because it's a much populated area. And I am playing on the older gen of Xbox. I'm playing on Xbox One S. I don't have the new ones yet. Still too much money to buy. But I do need to get a new one soon, though, because when Test Drive Solo Crowd comes out, that's only coming out on the newer generation of consoles, so I need to get that one eventually. And there is Dartford Crossing. get a bit foggy as well. Even though I like this part of the track, but I think this is too many tunnels. I can't enjoy the scenery that much. I suppose it'd be like we're in the Garden of England. You know, it's hidden most of the way. Like, even this side, you just got a wall. You know, you should be showing it off. Don't get me wrong, you've already seen much anyway, because you're going like 225 kilometers an hour. Still, it'd be nice to have that option just to have a decent view instead of going into tunnels all the time. Because we've got about a 6 mile long tunnel coming up soon. Downhill section, should be going to the tunnel. Here we go, downhill section. Here comes a darkness for about 6 miles. Just turn that annoying scrapey wiper off. A bit more speed now again. I know it's showing the end of the tunnel, but that's not. See, it disappears. Start getting some reduced speed soon. I think next one will be 200 very shortly, so I better go prepared for that, even though I'm not far off it. Anyway, there we go. We're going to go down to 200 in a minute. So I'm going to start bringing it down just a little bit. There we go, I'm at 200. Next one will be 160. I'll start bringing that one down. There we go. I'm going to keep on breaking down to 130 because that will be the next one. And I keep on breaking down to 100. lag. Always happens. And again. So probably won't reach 225 kilometres an hour again, so the next tunnel after Stratford is quite a short tunnel. So as soon as you start picking up your speed, you're going to start bringing it down again because you're putting it into St Pancras. I'm just going to let the train slow down naturally until I'm outside. And there's the outside. Get the wipers back on. Blinded by the light. Oh Jesus Christ, that is foggy. Is it still bloody raining or not? Oh, no, it's not. I'll turn these things off in a minute. I forgot how long this platform actually is. At least I'm not running late. Here we go. So after this will be the last stop when we get to St Pancras. I think it's only like about a 5-6 mile journey. Not many people going off here. Get ourselves ready to get off and close the door in about 5 seconds. There we go. Start going through the gears so we can leave bang on time. Doors are closed. Accelerate. Let's go. I always seem to slow down much earlier for that station. Jesus Christ, I can't see shit. Back up to 225, but I don't think we'll make it. It's only under 5 miles. Okay. get to 200, I think, if we make it to that. Another thing about this train is it's quite a modern train for the UK, and yet how rattly it is. I'm not even going to make it into 200. It's going to bring us down very quickly, isn't it? I'm not going to celebrate no more. There's no point. Not sure after that, we're going down to 160 again, so. I don't know, 130, so I'm going to continue braking because we've only got 2.7 miles, and I think we'll go down to about 40 when we go outside. And possibly have a red light, depending on if there's any other. Well, depending if we've got any space at the station. Point 2 miles left to go. Well, 1.1 now. Down to 80. So yeah. I do believe this is one of the longest routes on trains in the world. Three. Yeah, it is a very nice train. Right, so that one's green, so the next one after that should be green or yellow. The walls are white. It's a reflection of the fog. Should be getting an orange light soon. I'm bringing the speed down again because we've got to go 40. Oh, there's the orange light. Think we're gonna get a red. Normally red stops you at the bottom of a hill. That one just there on me was red. But I think we've got a clear run today. Platform 11. Ashton was not to be happy. That's just someone to crash at the end of this line. Because it is a dead end. Before I open up the doors and get the train set up to go back out, so I'm going to put the, I think it's mark lights. Nope. Tail lights, there we go. I'm going to open up the doors, put that off, take the key. Right, okay, that's me done for this one for today. I'd like to thank everybody who's been watching me on Twitch. If you have liked what you see, don't forget to hit that follow button. We will be playing another game later called Pyrex Drifting. And if I watch this later on YouTube, appreciate every single one of you. If you did hit that follow button or subscribe button and give us a like, that would be much appreciated. Hope everybody has a fantastic evening, and if you are watching on Twitch, and if you like watching some drifting, come back later for that. Take care, everybody. Thanks for watching. Peace.